back to the channel. Today's topic, what we're going to be talking about, is training with a partner and how this can benefit or maybe even take away from your workouts. It's something I don't really see a lot of people talking about, like the pros and cons of training with a partner. So I thought I'd go over it a wee bit. In terms of partner workouts, it's something I do think that can benefit you, but it's also something that I think takes away from people's workouts in some cases. Whether they notice it or not, it's something that's kind of in the back of your mind. You don't really think about it. But it could potentially be taken away from your workouts in some senses. I'm just going to go over a few things. So obviously we know the pros of training with a partner. Obviously it's good to have someone there to push you so you can push each other. If there's two of you or three of you, it's always good to kind of get that motivation, that kind of competitive nature out. You're trying to kind of one up each other, but it's also good kind of friendly competition. It's always a good frame of mind to be in when you're training with a partner, in terms of just motivation, inspiration, and just all round kind of try to help and push each other. Because when you are working out on your own, obviously you don't have someone there to do that for you. Having a spotter as well is obviously an important part, especially if you're lifting quite heavy. Obviously you want someone there to spot you. I always find that if I get someone random from the gym spotting me, it feels a bit weird, but obviously you want someone that you're close with, that you trust, that you're friends with, to spot you. It just feels a bit better in that sense, and they can motivate you as well. Especially if you're going for a PR, obviously it's very important to make sure that you have someone spotting you, just to prevent, you know, you dropping the weight on yourself or injuring yourself or whatever it may be. Also, it is good to have someone there for advice and help. Let's say you've just started the gym, you don't really know what you're doing, you're going with someone that does know what they're doing. Obviously that's going to help you quite a bit, instead of you just going in on your own and just, you know, winging it. This is something that kind of relates to me when I started the gym, because when I went into the gym for the first time, I did not know what I was doing. So my friend basically took me through everything and he showed me the ropes, just the kind of basics. And that's how I kind of got myself in the door. I don't think I could have done that on my own. But we're going to get into the cons now. So these are all great things that I've mentioned. Obviously, these are all really good benefits of training with a partner, but they can also kind of counteract themselves. So especially the pushing yourself thing, after a while, you can actually become less motivated, I've noticed. You're used to training with someone, you just become stuck in the same spot, you're not really pushing yourself as much. You're just kind of doing what you usually do. And it gets kind of less exciting when you're training with a partner, because the competitive nature kind of runs out. You're not really trying to one-up each other anymore. It's just kind of training together, and there's not much benefit to it, in my opinion. You're not as focused, and also this leads into the second point I'm going to make, distractions. So if you're working out with a partner, you can actually get talking to them, and this kind of takes away from like the atmosphere of the workout, chatting just absolute shit, you know, with your pals. Obviously this is all good and well when you're outside the gym, but when you're in it, obviously you want to stay focused, and it does kind of distract you from that. And I guess it takes away from your workout. For me anyway, I've had situations where I start talking to someone and then, you know, we're taking longer rest time because we're chatting, and it just gets a bit out of hand, and you know, it ruins the workout basically. I've had a lot of instances where that has actually happened. Also, you do not want to become reliant on someone. So if you go to the gym so much with someone and all you do is partner workouts with them, you don't train at all on your own, you're going to end up becoming reliant on them, and it just means that when they're not there, you're going to feel like the workouts maybe aren't as good. It goes both ways. I guess it just depends on the person. Everyone's different in this case, but I've found that nowadays I just prefer training on my own. I just feel more focused. I just like usually getting some caffeine in me, putting my headphones on, and just getting it done. Just really going for it. The solution for me is partner workouts are obviously really good in small doses, so occasionally. So the other day I was training with my friend, as you can see the footage, and it was really good workout. Obviously we hadn't trained together before, so it was kind of new experience, and also we have quite similar mindsets in terms of where we want to be, so it's good to have someone to push you that's in a similar state of mind as you. But if I was to do that all the time, I don't think my workouts wouldn't be nearly as good. So that's what I'm going to say to use, is you just want to kind of space it out. Personally, in my opinion, if you like working out with a partner and you're constantly motivated, that's great. I'm just giving you my experience from the matter, and I always feel like working out my own majority of the time, partner workouts occasionally, and that does it for me personally. So I'm about to go train with one of my mates, Sean, at his gym. We're gonna hit a bit of shoulders and arms today. I'm looking forward to it.
You Bruno. Vinny Idol, nigga. We be dipping in Maserati. Dipping. Used to slinging them pissy lobbies. I'm a D-block, nigga, if I violate mine, no niggas is getting body. You know? And I probably go get the shoddy. Dolo and Polo, I probably be playing shoddy. I wanted juice, but I gotta shoot a video. A nigga that swear that I'm not the truth. To say I never lied is a fucking lie. But who the fuck are you? Who the fuck am I? My mind is a prison and I'm stuck inside. Tuck a nine, fuck a dime. Get that money now, I don't know about another time. I only rhyme cause I love to rhyme. I work hard and yeah, me and the plug is fine. Can flood any hood with a ton of dimes. But I show my son my other side. Tell my daughter how it goes when a mother rides. On some other shit, love a rubber gripper, key flip. Moey on the yacht, never see sick. But get back home, you can see sick. You ain't got to look at the toilet to see shit. Got a gun, I call having to take a mean piss. I let it go cause they said I wouldn't be shit. You on my side or the other side? You on my shit or some other shit? Doing me, never cared what the others did.